my status on Facebook the first day of class when I first met Sam was, this class is gonna be awesome, and I said SOC 119. And then I had like 50 comments from like other people that took the class.
I hear students a lot talking about Sam, and they'll say, oh, Sam Richards, you know, and then they go on about how wonderful he was.
I see a lot of people stumble over political correctness, and I do too, but Sam is kind of fearless whenever he goes, like he's a dangerous person, right? He's one of the 100 most dangerous professors.
I want you to find a redneck in the class.
Oh, are you for real?
There aren't that many in here, I'll tell you, and there are many more brothers in here who got your back, so you're close, man. Come here. Dude, this is great. You are so wrong. I mean, what's your background?
Polish.
Pull it. Why'd you pick him, though? No, hang on. What did you just say?
I said they all look alike to me.
He's able to keep 700 people in his class at attention, listening to him.
Whites got into positions of power, so who's standing on top of the mountain? It's time to scramble up the mountain. I win. That's not bad for a working class schmuck like myself. Pretty cool. Come here, sit down. I'm gonna need you. Can I use you? Now I need 5 volunteers. You 2 guys, stand up real fast. Dude, come here. You brought this kid home to your family. Look at the eyes. Maybe on a table with duct tape. I don't have to slam my head in the door. I move down to the nose. Okay, I'm done. Can you shake it a couple times?
This definitely is theater. I mean, there's practically spotlights flying around the room and you know, welcome to the main event.
When I was taking the class, I thought that like the videos or like the music and the technology in that way was what caught my eye and kept me interested.
All right, what's it mean to be white? So you text it to that number, 99503, type white people in, space, and then put your text.
Because it's such an in-depth and important class, I think that he couldn't cut any of that technology out, that it is crucial to the class. It extends the classroom. In my opinion, it feels like I'm getting more for my money. The credits I paid for don't just end in the classroom.
At the top of the room, we have flip cameras. Definitely gotta kick your question into the flip cameras because we're gonna put them up on the blog tonight, and then we're gonna blog about them. Right, straight guys, especially those of you who are involved in fraternal organizations. All I'm gonna say is there's a lot of homoerotic activity that happens.
Okay, so my question is, what do you guys think about male gay couples? Because you put a bunch of guys in a group together,
just when they're living together in rooms and buildings, you put guys in a room, they gotta prove that they're straight.
I feel like he has such an unbiased view of everything.
Those of you who claim to be conservative, and you know who you are.
I feel he's fairly far to the left.
Sam identified himself as conservative.
He's definitely in the middle.
You have to account for free will, which you already do, or you should, because that's the essence of conservatism. But you also have to account for factors and forces outside of people's control.
He doesn't necessarily press his views, he just presses views that makes you think differently outside of the box.
The liberal and Democrat side, who tends to lean toward thinking that factors and forces outside of people's control explain everything that happens to them, you cannot discount or deny that people make individual decisions.
When I go into Sam's class, without a doubt, there's no other place in time or on this earth that I should be than in that class. And the information he's giving me is what I'm supposed to be hearing.
Let's say about 12% of the women in this room have had some kind of sexual experience. And it might actually be a little higher because it's college and you're experimenting when you're in college and so on. So about 12%. So that's what is that, like 1 out of 8? So 1 out of 8 women in here. That's a lot of women. Certainly by the time you leave college. It's a lot of people. Doesn't mean you're gay. About 5% of you all, of the men in here. So, you know, we could count, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 19. Dude, you're gay.
He's done exactly what he said he would do. It makes you think. Especially the class about inequality. I mean, that did make me, I had to really reevaluate some of the beliefs I held.
Can you see the strings? It's like he's a puppet. Man, his arms are out. And you see the strings coming down. I see the strings coming down. They're shaping him. Look, one string, he's a man. Are you straight or gay? He's straight. He wears his hat cocked to the side. He's black.
I can choose not to act black.
You can choose not to act. What's acting black, dude?
I don't know. You tell me.
Here, this is right here, man. Right there. All right, so hang on.
It's tight.
There.
It's tight.
All right, let's get the hoodie down. Let's take the hoodie off. The whole nine yards. You can choose not to act black. But dude, but even then, you're still gonna see you as black.
Sam has a trust. I think students know that Sam's not gonna shove something down your throat, but he is going to challenge you.
And it's not just gonna be another activist talking, it's gonna be a professor that they already trust and respect talking to them about something that's important.
Let's imagine they come into the classroom and they're walking down the mall like this. Anybody notice them? Is anyone gonna even take a second look? No, you're not, right? Imagine these guys. All right, so you're at the mall. And you watch them walk. Do you notice it? Of course you notice it. They're not flaunting. What, are they flaunting it? Well, now they are. Look, they're totally flaunting it. But they're not flaunting it any more than they're flaunting it. Like, what is this that we're talking about here?
One thing that he brings up that it's brought up but not brought up enough is the fact that there's multiple sides to the race equation.
It's a challenge that people of color aren't used to having. Like he said, I mean, when you talk about inequality, black people are just like, oh, well, you know, this part doesn't apply to me.
You're African American? You got a cell phone? Dude. There are parts in this cell phone. It's a BlackBerry? Dude, nice. All right. There are parts of this BlackBerry that have been made by slaves. Okay? Components of this. Clothing made by slaves. You can't really, it's not easy to talk about slavery in the past and reparations and so on and so forth when you yourself are benefiting from slavery.
He's changed my perspective about everything.
The course did change my life in a way. You know, words that would have never bothered me before.
He certainly has changed my mind about a lot of things throughout the class.
Definitely like planted a seed for me to continue learning.
He challenged me a lot, but in a good way, because the way he challenged me is kind of what inspired me to really get into these discussions.
And it's taught me about people and about me and about the way the world works. And it's been the best thing that has ever happened to me by far, no doubt. No doubt.
Well, we'll see you on the vlog tonight.